He never lost his fire in serving the Lord. He goes out on Bible studies every week and teach people the Word of God. That's one thing I admire about Brother Danny.
Amen.
Another letter F that I will use to describe him is he is very fruitful. He is fervent. He is fruitful. Meron siyang three kids, Sister Marge and Brother Mark and Brother Matt. And of course, two of them are married with great families. And hindi ko nadadagdagan yun. And he loves the Lord. And the third letter F is very faithful. He had been a Christian for a long, long time. And he still served the Lord and keeps on serving the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
I hope that we will copy his example. Listen with your heart today as we go through this outline. Let us give our speaker a big BBC and welcome, Brother Danny. You come and give us the Word of God.
Thank you very much, Pastor. And it is also my pleasure how God also blesses us. This morning, this is one of the very important messages that I would like also to share with you. As we go on to this message this morning, may I invite the congregation to stand up and let us open our Bible in the book of Psalm chapter 1.
Amen.
Psalm chapter 1. In this book of Psalm chapter 1, there are only 6 verses that we can learn a lot from this book. And let us read all together, starting from verse 1 up to verse 6. If you are ready, just say amen.
Amen.
Okay, begin.
Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. And his law that remaineth day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the godly shall be perished.
Let's bow our head for our prayer. O God, Heavenly Father, we thank Thee once again, Lord, this wonderful day. As we are going against Lord to express and bring the message that You would like us to hear this morning. Lord, I pray also this great congregation that continue to open our spiritual eyes, spiritual ears, and spiritual hearts, Lord, to listen to the message of Thy words this morning. Pray, Lord, the Holy Spirit will continue to speak to us, guide us, and give us the knowledge and understanding that we continue, Lord, to live a blessed life as You have given to us, Lord. This morning, Lord, we pray and thank Thee, Your servant, Lord, we pray and that anoint my lips with the Holy Spirit, that all my witness that You can say, Lord, but the cross of our Lord and Savior who died in the cross of Calvary to save our soul. All the things we pray in the name of Lord Savior. Amen. Okay, you may be seated. As I'm listening also my interpreters about the singing of the choir, I always remember how my Lord has been crucified, and I was also a sinner at the time, and I did not realize that we have the great Savior who had been crucified at the cross to give us an eternal life. But this morning, if you go through our hands out, this is one thing also that I would like to share to you, that counting how has God blessed us in this blessed life. The title of this message this morning is about the characteristic of a blessed believer. You know, my dear brethren, there are many artistic, a natural man, and even a carnal man, used to measure being blessed in this life. But now, usually, they don't call it anymore blessing, but rather they refer it to a prosperous and a success. Among these things, the people of this world are looking at are the position. Of course, well, in his broadest definition, power, position, prestige, name of this top world, these are the indicators of a worldly prosperity and success. This morning, but how God measures success? Measuring our success as a Christians is, and that should be different from this world.
Amen.
In the Psalms, we have the insight into what makes a believer successful and blessed. This morning again, my dear brethren, as a plumb line of God's word move alongside in your life, and please see yourself just how you measure up to the God's standard of blessed or a successful Christian living.
Amen.
As we move to the Psalms, my dear brethren, let me share you this characteristic of how a blessed life or a successful believers or a blessing of obedience. Always remember, my dear brethren, blessings of obedience. And every person on earth, sin or not, wanted to be blessed in life. Do you?
Amen.
Yes, of course. Amen. Me also. But one thing that you have to put in mind, my dear brethren, is that our deeds that give us this characteristic of a person is a truly blessed. I am only talking about a blessed Christians believing in the Lord, our Savior Jesus Christ, who is our Creator in this world.
Amen.
Number one is the path of a blessed believer. A path of a blessed believer. As we have read in this text of Psalms chapter 1, is you can notice that blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. It's very clear. Mapagpala ang isang tao na hindi siya lumalakad sa mga lakad ng hindi makajus.
Amen.
It is very clear what the Bible is saying here. Even the psalmist is always declared that blessed is a man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor is standeth and the sinners that seated on the seat of discomfort. This is a very clear that the blessed believer is separated in the walk of his life.
Amen.
Kung tayo po ay mananampalataya na ay we are already been separated by God from darkness into the light.
Amen.
Because God wanted us to follow his step. You can say to me, Brother Danny, it's so very difficult to follow the lifestyle of our Jesus Christ. But we, as I believe, my dear brethren, that we can do that.
Amen.
We need to be grateful to the words of God.
Amen.
Notice that the downward progress that one see the sun. A believer doesn't believe in a wicked or the invitations of the invitations into heaven. And Jesus always remember my dear brethren, if you are already a believer or a saved one, you have now a higher hearing in everywhere. Any invitations for this worldly pleasure, you have now the discernment to think of, because you always put in your heart that we are already been separated. See, a Christian, he doesn't belong to the wicked groups anymore.
Amen.
He doesn't listen to the counsel or the invitation. His hearing is turned up higher than those unseen people.
Amen.
He doesn't behave the wicked actions of this world anymore.
Amen.
Because according to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 15, that if any man be in Christ, he is a new creator.
Amen.
You are already having a new nature. The old nature has been put off, and the new man has already put in order for us to walk according to the word that was given to us, according to the Lord. He doesn't belong, as according also, he doesn't belong to the wicked group.
Amen.
He is separate in the living belief. Like 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 7, the Bible says that wherefore come out from among them.
So he says that.
The Bible says that come out among them and be separate.
Amen.
And that's not the unclean thing. And I will receive you, saying the Lord.
Amen.
Imagine. And what is the Bible also? Give us also a terms of we are a peculiar. If you are saved, you are the son of God, you are a peculiar son of God.
Amen.
Ikaw lang ay natatanging tao ng anak ng Diyos. Dahil ikaw ay hiniwala niya sa sanlibutan na ito. Mga kapatid.
Amen.
Notice also that the darling tradition, how abusive Christian walk, how he stand, and how is he? From the walking and advice influences of younger people, he has to be careful.
Amen.
He has already separated, as I said before. Standing and agreement and alignment with them is no longer to be fellowship with them. The sitting and collusion with them in the scorn against the righteousness to the righteous. It's no longer, as according to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 17, that be separate. Amen. He analyzes that is, always remember, that if you are a blessed believer, my dear brethren, there is a big vast different himself and the world that we are being set out. Why? Because, as if we consider that we have a blessed believers, we seek to walk and live and conduct your living according to the word of God.
Amen. Amen.
A blessed believer is always put in his heart all these teachings of the Bible. Number one, the path of the blessed believer, there is a blessing walking in God's ways instead. Number two, the pleasure of a blessed believer. This is found in the Psalms chapter 1 verse 2. But his delight is the law of the Lord, and it is law that meditate day and night. So you can have here how the values of the word. The word has captured the full attention, and delight is equal to the pleasure. Has the word of God captured your attention, my dear brethren? The word that captured your full attention, the word of God, isn't that a book of pebbles, or meat, as the others say, especially unbelievers. Ang salita po ng Diyos ay hindi po ito ay isang mga katalamang.
Amen.
So, ito po ay mga alamat o mga legend, mga kapatid. Para, for the believers, the Word of God is the truth of word for his life.
Amen.
According to the Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 13, for this cause also, thanks be to God, without ceasing, because when we receive the word of God, which you heard of us, you receive it not as the word of man, but it is the truth, the word of God, which effectually worketh also that believe. So, there are the values. You can find out all the values of word here. It is the food. It is a spiritual food. You can find out in John chapter 23, verse 12. You can have now all the references by their brethren. When you are in your house, you can read and meditate all the values of words of God that we are studying and learning this morning.
Amen. Amen.
It's not only the spiritual food. It is also the spiritual milk.
Amen.
1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2. As a newborn bread, desire the sincere milk of the word that you may grow by. Katulad ng isang bata, mga kapatid, bagong panganak, katulad ng yung anak ng ating pong mga kapatid, from day to day, hour by hour, they have to be fed by the sincere word. The same as also a baby Christian, we need also to drink the sincere word of God that we may grow by, strong and healthy as a Christian. So,
amen.
The word of God is not only a spiritual milk, but is also a spiritual meat, according to Hebrews chapter 5, verse 1. It provides all we need as we nurture to make us strong in the Lord. It is not only a spiritual meat, but it is also a spiritual bread. According to Matthew chapter 4, verse 4, that a man cannot live by bread alone, but every word proceed it in the mouth of the Lord. So this is very clear that it is a spiritual food of a believer. A bread is, you know already that the bread is our staple food, especially in this world. Wherever you go, it is the part of a diet of a people. The same thing way to the mouth. The bread is always represent in me is the word of God. It is also an spiritual honey. When you see spiritual honey, when I read the articles of one nutritionist, and he said, honey is the perfect food, not only sweet, but it does not spoil. Is the word of God is really spoiled? No. I believe that the word of God is always praised, especially to us a believer.
Amen.
You can also read. There are so many cross references that I put there, my dear brethren, so that you can learn and study and meditate while you are in your house or you are in your office. So, it is a spiritual night. According to Book of Psalm 119:105, that the word is the lamp unto my feet.
Amen.
And the light unto my feet. Don't you know that we live in the world and spiritual darkness by sins, by the brethren?
Amen.
This is our life, and this is the love of our food. There is nothing that we can give the direction to our life on the path of the Word of God. Wala na mga kapatid, kundi nakakapagbigay ng matuwid ng ating pong kalakaran, kundi ang salita lamang ng ating pong Panginoon. Nakatulad, it is like, we can read also in the book of 1 Peter, chapter 1, verse 19. What is this apostle say? That they have the sure word, meaning to see the sure word, meaning to see that who can walk straight. They can walk straight and very sure, according to this word that Peter, that we have also the more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well that ye take him as unto the light, and shine it darkly until the day dawn and the day star arise your heart. The word of God, my dear brethren, is not only it was true, spiritual truth. John 17, sanctify them through thy truth, and their word is truth.
Amen.
Falsehoods abound in this world, my dear brethren. Even the biggest or the largest religion in this world, but only the word of God can sanctify us so that we are set apart from God for His promises and purpose, my dear brethren.
Amen.
The word of God is not only a spiritual food, but it is also a spiritual mirror to us. James chapter 1, 23. It shows what is wrong in our life so that we can correct it.
Amen.
It shows our life what's wrong so that it can correct us. So this is a spiritual mirror according to James chapter 1, 23-25. If you will notice that there is also a fourfold probability of the scripture. If you are going to read 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. And the Bible says that the word of that the scripture is given by inspiration of God.
Yes.
It is profitable for doctrine,
yes.
Profitable for correction, for reproof, for corrections, and for instruction, that the man of God may be perfect to really furnish unto him. So you can see that why it is it a profitable for the plane? Because it says what is right.
Amen.
Why it says a profitable for reproof? Because it tells us what is wrong.
Amen.
Why it says profitable for correction? In order to fix what's wrong and make it right.
Amen.
Profitable for instructions in the righteousness. Meaning to say that we should always stay on the right track. This
Amen.
Is what the Bible says to us. The Word of God is not only a spiritual for another everything. It is also a spiritual water according to the Ephesians chapter 5 verse 27. That the water cleanses us. The waters cleanse our thirst away. And taking needs and according to thy word. The spiritual water is also cleanses our thirst according to the book of Isaiah, chapter 55:1. For everyone that thirsted, come to the water.
Amen.
Have you ever quenched your thirstiness by drinking those colas? No. I have already experienced this thing, my friend. When we were, one time we are in the seaside, been there for about maybe 4 hours, 5 hours, staying in the beach. But when the waters, we run out of waters, and we still have those colas there, we try to drink colas and everything, but the more thirst that we experience. But until that one of us run and buy gallons of water and drink it, then all our thirst quenches out. This is also the word of God. That is like a water that quenches. Jesus said in John chapter 7, verse 37, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. So it is only the word of God that can cleanse us. The word of God can refresh us.
Amen.
The word of God is only can save us, my dear brethren. Spiritual water, it replaces as a cold water to thirst to our thirsty soul. So it's good news also to us that it is only the word of God, it's like a water that like a cold water that can quench our thirsty souls. It is not only a spiritual food, but it's also our spiritual soul. According to Hebrews chapter 2, for verse 12, that the word of God is quick, than is sharper than to any, quick and powerful than to any aged sword. Huh? So this is a really powerful. Pressing even to the binding asunder of souls and spirit and the joint and marrow, and it is the discerners of thought and intents of the heart. So this is it. Even the most vilest sinners in this world, my dear friend, even the most stony-hearted person, the moment he heard the word of God and the Spirit spoke to him, you will be surprised how this stony-hearted person, as I experienced also when we are doing, conducting a Bible studies about 2 years ago in Wakra, people, friends, Filipinos telling us that these two persons are hard, are stony hard. But thanks God, when we prayed, we started Bible study, and I am teaching you about the salvations of the souls, how the souls that the souls died without the Lord, he will go to hell. And after our Bible studies, and I asked an invitation, who among them would like to receive the Lord Jesus Christ? And I have seen those two persons that have told me that they have the stony heart, raised their hand, and they believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and they got saved, and praise the Lord on that. So this is also the kind, the word of God is like a sword. It's like a sword. And also, not only the word of God is a spiritual tool, but is also a spiritual hammer. Don't you know that hammer can break? Can the hammer can build also? So this is the detail how the word can crush you out the moment you hear and have a faith and hear the word of God. The Holy Spirit will hammer you out and break your heart, and your stony heart will become a fleshy heart. The word of God is not only a hammer. A blessed believer, I believe that most of a blessed believer in us in love with the Bible. If we are in love with the Bible, it's meant to say that we know that it is every pages we can find all what requires of our souls. Because the word of God contains the complete revelations of God to all men, that it meets all the needs of a Christian life. Do you love the Bible? Is the word of God capture your heart with the full affection? This is my question to you there, brethren. Is the word of God has captured your full attention this morning? The word a blessed believer has captured his full attention. Not only does a blessed believer love the book, but he seeks to live the book daily in his work. The word of God, the Bible means that it should be the internalized to become a singular standard of our faith and practice in our life. And a believer that lives in his life that way knows and experiences the blessings of God in his life. Our every thought, our every move, and our every decision is to be made against the backdrop of God's word and what it has to say about the issue. However, before life can ever leave this passion, find yourself consumed with the contents and mesmerize the meditations of men. The Bible is never been when it is read and studied and lived. I repeat, the Bible is never better than when it is read and studied and then in liberal living. The one, the path of a blessed believer. Number two, the pleasure of the blessed believer. And number three, the prosperity of a blessed believer. In verse 3, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season, and his leaf shall, and his leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever doeth shall prosper. The promise of these verses are conditional, my dear brethren. When we live separated lives and feed our souls in God's word, then we can expect this thing to happen for us. His position by the river is always close to the living, giving resources. That is the position of a tree, like us. If we are always close and connected to the Word of God, then God is always prosper us in our daily life. B, His prominence. Men will know when you have been with Jesus.
Amen.
Prominence. Men will know when we have been in Jesus. You can read it on Acts chapter 4, verse 13. See, His permanence, meaning you are planted. He has sunk its root deep and has hidden to the source of life. Unlike other plants which live to a season and die out. And the tree that is planted by the rivers of water sing its roots and draws deeply from the flowing source of life, so also the life of a blessed believer, he has his life planted deeply by the Lord, ever flowing source. D, his reconductivity, reproductivity brings forth fruit. You will see in John chapter 17, verse 2. Productivity, meaning to say, if we are a faithful or a blessed believer, bringing forth his fruit. A blessed believer is blessings to all those around him. Because his fruit is plentiful, we will never know just who is feeding to our life. For example, my dear, if you have planted a tree, and you see also maybe there are 5 or 10 fruit on that tree, do you think you are so happy? No. Of course no. But if you see another tree that is bringing much fruit, how do you feel? You feel happy, isn't it? So this is also supposed to be a Christian living, my dear brethren, that we are always be connected, like a tree planted in the tree's water, so that we continue to bear fruit. And number one is our testimony. That's also the picture of our testimony. That we are always faithful to the Lord.
Amen.
E, his predictability. There are times of the risk of road. You can read it in John chapter 15, 1 to 5. That I am the branch, and the true vine, what the Lord says, and my Father is the husbandman. So, God, if you have been always connected to the vine, then the branches is always also healthy as a Christian being. Just as there are seasons of fruit bearing, so there are times of both trees and growth. As a believer, we are not to worry over the fruit. That is the Father's business.
Amen.
When everything else is at the shooting, then the fruit will come at the season. This is exactly what I have said. That fruit is always come in a season. There is no tree that continuously bear fruit for a year. And I don't see any trees. That was starting from January, February, March, until terms continues bearing fruit. But as a Christian, I do believe we should continue to bear much fruit, my dear.
Amen.
As a Christian, not a tree. His perpetuity bring forth fruit. See John Peter 7. The successful believer is like an evergreen. He is always manifesting the signs of life. Mean to say, we have always the good testimony, that this good testimony can bring us full out unbeliever that diminishes also our good. Our life should be lives of consistency. That is very important to us as Christians. Consistency. We are called by the Lord to be stable, faithful, and dependable people. That is, you can find in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58. G, his prosperity, whatsoever he doeth, shall prosper.
Amen.
God will bless him. So you notice, brother, brother, in other words, God's will, blessings are evidence in his life. His personal life, his family life, his business life, like Joseph in Genesis chapter 2. His church life. How about you, my dear friend? How is your church life? His spiritual life. How is your spiritual life, my dear friend? In every area of his life will show that he is blessed of the Lord.
Amen.
That is easy to say, hindi na ito nahulugan na wala nang bagyo sa ating buhay. It is not easy to say that one fish tarnishes at times, but the blessed believer will be able to seal those tarnishes with Jesus until the Lord chooses to calm them once again. Like I remember about 2 years ago when our pastor preaches to us about the back of the valley. Sometimes we are down, but because of our faithfulness to God, that one day it will turn up. So this is the kind also, as a Christian, huwag natin isipin na habang tayo po ay masagana, mga kapatid, na hindi na tayo dadaan pa ng mga daluyong sa ating buhay. No, wrong. We should always prepare ourselves. Kinakailangan natin na pagdaanan natin na tayo po ay tapat sa Panginoon palagi, or we have been connected, not disconnected to the true one.
Amen.
In conclusion, my dear brethren, do you possess this characteristic of blessed believer? The word blessed here I means how very, very happy. I hope through this message that you have seen yourself among these blessed ones and are encouraged about your walk with Jesus. See, it is possible to be a blessed of a Christ unknown without being self-righteous about him. But if you see yourself lacking in one of these areas that we have talked about, then the Lord stands ready, willing and able to help you make things right in your life, in our life, where you too can be blessed. Why not take whatever step that is necessary to ensure that your life is well? It can be blessed to the maximum by the Lord. But always remember, it is always begin in salvation.
Amen.
Okay, let's bow our head and I will call our pastor.
Every head bowed, every eye closed. Please, no looking around. Let me ask everyone.